family and friends, happy Friday! We come to the end of another week and the end of another month. When we come back together on Monday, it will be August. Oh my gosh. But anyway, guys, it's our cold reading Friday. We started to read the movie scripts now. I think it will be really fun. I have a really fun plan today. And I just thought, since we're working on some blockbusters for the trivia, a lot of our cold readings are going to be from some blockbuster movies. But I won't tell you that till we do some moving and grooving, and then we'll get to our cold reading for today. All right? Song I can they allow to be played over YouTube. So just know that. But anyway, guys, great warm up. Just really feel this, right? Getting ready to do some cold reading. So shake that out. Shake that out. Good. Roll your shoulders. All right. And then just bring your arms in front, so your arms are straight out in front of you. You're going left over right and right over left. Your right, left hand goes over your left, right, and then your right hand goes over your left. All right, good, good. Shake that out. Take a couple deep breaths. Pull out. Another deep breath. Pull out. Just chew a bit. Get our mouth muscles going. Maybe it's your first class of the day. So, you know, you just want to warm up. Take your palms of your hands, the heels of your hands, and just rub your jaw, rub your face a little bit. And you're doing that with the heels of your hands. That, so you're not doing your whole, but you're not touching your whole hand with your face. With just the heels of your hand and arm and a meat. Good. Cool. All right. So I started to introduce Phoebe to a cold play reading, but I really find that doing the movie script reading is going to do our cold reading, then it would be a lot of fun. So what is our cold? We're just going to call it cold play readings. It was a screenplay. So, what is a cold play reading today from? Jaws! That's right, we're gonna do some meetings from jars. Again, guys, you may take it out of context a little bit when I coach you through it, but it really is just to continue to work on the habit of not just reading the script, but even with cold reading, adding the emotional values, really living truthfully in an imaginary circumstance. So that's what the casting director wants to see. Yes, you may or may not be off book, but it's your connection to the material and your ability to make the connection to the material right away, okay? That's what I do casting director workshops. I listen and study, but I'm also an actor. Those are what casting directors are looking for. Your ability, you're gonna connect to that material. So the script, script. So our scenes, our reading today are from Jaws, that came out in 1975, written by none other than Steven Spielberg. So we're gonna go to that. I will coach you through it. We'll come back, shake it out, go to another one, all right? Let's go to the first one. All right, guys, here's the first one. And again, these might be scenes and something you're saying that's similar to the movie, very similar to the movie, okay? So for this first one, imagine you're the mayor of the town. You all have been very concerned about the shark Jaws that has been terrorizing the town. You're talking to the sheriff, who you don't get along with. The sheriff is smoking in your office. It's making you mad. You say, "Do not smoke in here. Thank you very much." So you're really you're frustrated already, and then the sheriff lights up a cigarette, and you say, "Do not smoke in here. Thank you very much." All right, so that action of seeing the sheriff light up a cigarette, and you're, "Do not smoke in here. Thank you very much." Good, let's try that again. He lights up the cigarette. You're frustrated. "Do not smoke in here. Thank you very much." Good, let's try that one more time. "Do not smoke in here. Thank you very much." Good, and those are all about reacting. You're reacting to seeing that cigarette be lit up. Let's do it one more time. Sorry for my computer noise. You see the cigarette light up, the sheriff lights up the cigarette. "Do not smoke in here. Thank you very much." Good, guys, good. All right, good, shake that off. Shake that off. Good. All right, good. Guys, continue to find that emotional value, that connection of using the live truthfully in the imaginary circumstance. What is going on? How are you reacting to your environment in the imaginary circumstance? All right, let's go to number two. Okay, guys, good. Now imagine you're on the boat, you're the sheriff and the fisherman, and you're looking for the shark, and all of a sudden you see it coming at you. The shark is swimming toward the boat very quickly. You see him in your binoculars and you say, Boys, I think he's come back with noon feeding." So you're nervous. It's like the shark is just charging at you, coming towards the boat very quickly. All right? And action. "Boys! Oh, boys! I think he's come back with noon feeding." So you're trying to warn people. You're nervous. Let's do it again. And action. "Boys! Oh, boys! I think he's come back for noon feeding." Okay, good. Again, warnings. scared, nervous. Let's do it again. You see the shark? Maybe make you fake binoculars? Boys! Oh, boys! I think he's come back for a noon feeding! Good, let's do that again. Nervous, ready, and action. Boys! Oh, boys! I think he's come back for a noon feeding! Good job. Alright, good guys, good job. Keep going again, guys, we're using our imagination. That's the biggest tool we have at our disposal of actors, which is just to imagine. Alright, just imagine and what it's like. And we go to our third one. Okay guys, so this one is a little bit longer. We're gonna take it slow. You're a person in the town and you're very upset right now because the sharks are out there and it affected you personally. Someone you loved was very hurt by the sharks, okay? The sharks. So, alright? And died but killed by the shark, and so you're very, very upset, okay? You knew there was a shark out there! You knew it was dangerous! But you let people go to me anyway? You knew all those things? So again, imagine you're in the town meeting, like a town meeting, you're hearing the sheriff apologize, and you get upset, you stand up and you say, you knew there was a shark out there! You knew it was dangerous! But you let people go swimming anyway! You knew all those things! Alright, remember that question there. Like, how could you do that? Alright, let's try it again. Really upset, emotional, guys. You don't have to be crying. But I want you to be in that. How could someone let this happen? How could you let a shark be out there and not tell us? How could you do that? You're very accusing the sheriff. You're very upset. Let's do it again. You knew there was a shark out there! You knew it was dangerous! But you let people go swimming anyway! You knew all those things! Good, let's do it one more time together. You're doing really great. It's really... find the rage, the anger, whatever it is, that how could they let this happen, okay? The sheriff. Ready, and you knew there was a shark out there! You knew it was dangerous! But you let people go to me anyway! You knew all those things! Good job, guys. Really, really good job. Good. And before we go on to our fourth one, let's take a couple deep breaths. Good, and another deep breath. Take the focus. Yeah, they're doing really great. I'm really, really proud of you. Let's go to our fourth one. Okay, guys, here we go. I want you to imagine that you were on the fishing boat. You are a fisherman, you're looking for the shark, but you're very sarcastic. So when you see this cage, you react, that shark will rip that cage to pieces. You think it's a stupid cage, and the reaction is, this is the dumbest idea. So I feel very sarcastic, this is stupid, okay? So you see the cage? You look at the cage? That shark will rip that cage to pieces. Alright, there's like annoying, sarcastic. Okay, let's do it again. Let's show you the cage. That shark will rip that cage to pieces. Okay, one more time. That shark will rip that cage to pieces. Good job, good job. Alright, great job today guys, let's just shake all that off. We did a lot of good work, we did a lot of emotion work, guys. Sometimes we're going to get auditions you gotta have. We call them for scenes where you have to be emotional, so I want to work on that too. Alright, and I always want everything to be funny, but I also want afterwards, if you do something emotional, let's really shake it off. Take a deep breath. Good. So you're really just making sure you got all that out. And another great way to feel better is today at the Move It and Groove It. So we're going to move it and groove it because we had another great, awesome week. You guys did good. You guys did great. I love you, I miss you, and I'll see you on Zoom on Monday!